Hai, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bertemu kembali dengan Madam Maziah dalam topik 9, Wireless LAN. And ini merupakan bahagian kedua kita akan look at about Bluetooth. Bluetooth merupakan wireless LAN technology designed to connect the device of different functions such as phone, notebook, computer, camera, printer, coffee maker and so on. Alright, Bluetooth LAN adalah ad hoc network, which means that the network is formed spontaneously. In Bluetooth LAN, the device called as a gadget. A Bluetooth LAN by nature cannot be large sebab dia punya network adalah small compared kepada wireless 802.11 kita belajar sebelum ini. Alright, this architecture about Bluetooth. Alright, Bluetooth define two type of network. Pertama, we call as Picanet, and another one adalah Scatternet. Right, Picanet can have up to 8 session, one of which is called as primary and the rest are called as secondary. Kita akan tengok figure selepas ini. Scatternet adalah is a combination of Picanet. Alright, secondary session in one Picanet can be primary in another Picanet. Alright, so this is the architecture of we call as Picanet. Alright, selepas ini kita akan tengok Scatternet. Alright, again, alright, this Picanet adalah alright merupakan alright is a network combine beberapa session inside yang mana kat sini dia punya value ataupun dia punya number adalah up to 8 network. Alright. Up to 8 network. Alright. Okay, jap. Kat mana dia explain tadi? Have up to 8 session. Alright. Mempunyai sampai 8 session including primary. And it have one adalah primary and the rest adalah secondary. So, we can have one as primary and we can have up to 7 as secondary. This is Picanet. Alright. And another one adalah Scatternet adalah made up daripada lebih daripada satu Picanet. Right, this one adalah one Picanet, this one adalah another Picanet, and the secondary, alright, secondary station in one Picanet tadi boleh jadi primary to another Picanet. Alright, this is Scatternet. It's made up dari lebih daripada satu Picanet combine, and we can make a larger network. Alright, dia menjadikan secondary dalam Picanet tersebut sebagai primary to another Picanet. Alright, that is Scatternet. Alright, kita tengok seterusnya ialah Bluetooth layer. Bluetooth use several layer do not exactly match those of the internet model. The layer adalah radio, baseband, L2CAP and others. Kita akan tengok satu per satu. Alright, so tadi lah we have radio layer, baseband layer, L2CAP. Alright, and we have application layer. Alright, so kita tengok radio layer. Roughly equivalent kepada physical layer dalam internet network ataupun internet model, Bluetooth device are low power and have range only 10 meter. Alright, dia dalam network yang small, only can work in 10 meter. Bluetooth use the frequency hop spread spectrum ataupun we call FHSS method. Alright, each device use a frequency for only 725 microseconds before it hop to another frequency. Bluetooth use a sophisticated version of FSK called as GFSK ataupun FSK with Gaussian bandwidth filtering. Alright, apa itu baseband layer? This layer is roughly equivalent kepada MAC sublayer dalam local network. The primary and secondary communicate each other using time slot. The length of time slot adalah again sama 625 microsecond and the communication is only between master and slave. Right, Bluetooth use a form of TDMA called TDDD TDMA, time division duplex TDMA. TDD TDMA is a kind of half duplex communication in which the secondary and receiver send and receive data but not at the same time. Kita akan tengok in detail selepas ini dalam figure. Alright, we have alright this one lah talking about baseband tadi. We have two type. We have single secondary communication. This baseband layer. Nampak? We have two type. Yang pertama adalah single. We call a single secondary communication. Alright. Alright. So, what means by single secondary communication? Only one session here. Alright, so only one secondary station. Alright, if the picnic has only one secondary, the time is divided into slot of 625 microseconds. The primary use even number slot. Alright, even number slot lah number genap. And the sub use ataupun the secondary use odd number slot. In slot 0, the primary send, the secondary receive. Alright, so this one again primary use even ataupun genap. Dalam slot number 0, F0, primary send the data. Alright, it requires 625 microsecond. Alright, so in slot number 1, the secondary send again. Alright, send the data. Alright, ataupun kita panggil hope. Alright, the primary receive, the second is repeated. This one adalah considered in single secondary communication, only one secondary in that PicoNet. Alright, so dalam multiple secondary, alright, multiple secondary is mean if the PicoNet has more than one secondary, the process is literally more complex. Alright, so this example, kita terus tengok figure. Alright, so this example, in PicoNet, we have two secondary of two session. Alright, in slot number 0, primary send the frame. Alright, send the hook. Alright, so now send the data. Okay, jap me. Alright, so dalam slot number 0, primary send a frame kepada secondary. Alright, and frame number 1, secondary will send back frame kepada primary. Alright, frame number 2, primary will send the frame ataupun face number 2. Alright, primary will send the frame kepada secondary number 2. Alright, kemudian slot number 3, alright, secondary number 2 will send back the data kepada primary. This inside we call as multiple secondary communication sekiranya PicoNet itu mempunyai lebih daripada satu secondary. Alright, so next kita tengok, alright, physical link. There are two type of link. Alright, this is physical link. There are two type of link. Pertama adalah SCO. Alright, yang kedua adalah ACL. Apa itu SCO? Apa itu ACL? SCO adalah we call as synchronous connection oriented link is used when avoiding latency. Delay in data delivery is more important than integrity. This one adalah we call as latency yang paling penting. Alright, ACL adalah kita panggil adalah integrity is much more important. Alright, apa maksudnya adalah in physical link, there are two types. We have SCO dan ACL. SCO adalah latency much important. It means that, alright, it means that very fast. We need send the data and receive faster. Alright, in term of accuracy ialah ACL. In term of accuracy, we don't care about error-free delivery. Maksudnya, we don't care about sama ada data itu tepat, betul ataupun tidak. Because we just care about the delay or about the latency. ACL is different. The most important adalah integrity is much more important compared to latency. Must be accurate, must be tepat, must be precise. Alright, that is different between SCO dengan ACL. Alright, this frame format, a frame in the baseband layer can be one of three type, one slot, three slot, or five slot. Alright, so this one, okay, kita tak perlu tengok in details. Alright, and then kita tengok L2CAP. The logical link control and adaption protocol L2CAP is roughly equivalent kepada LSC sublayer in local area network. The format of data packet consists of three fields. Alright, ada tiga field. We have here LAN, channel ID, dan juga data and control. The L2CAP has several specific duties which is do the multiplexing, segmentation and reassembly, quality of service and group management. Alright, itu sahaja topik part 2 dalam Bluetooth. Alright, selamat belajar dan kita jumpa lagi dalam topik seterusnya. Okay, bye. Assalamualaikum.